to store an IP lookup table, IP address lookup table using a binary trie and perform binary trie search and find the next hop. So how we are supposed to store is, given an IP address in binary, assuming 1 0 1 1 0, you should find the odd position bits. Those are these. There is 1 2 and 3, and even position bits, that is 4 and 5, and store the odd bits in an odd trie and by the even bits in the even trie. So we use total of 2 tries to perform this action.
5 is even? 5.
No, no, no. Number bit of your time. Change the number. 1, 3, and 2, and 4. These are odds and they are even. So how? We cannot implement a trie using CUDA, so we have used an array to map a trie to in this one. So how we map the array is using 2 formulas. Which are if the current bit is 0, bit is 0, index is equal to index into 2 plus 1. If equal to 1, index is equal to index into 2 plus 2. So I will demonstrate how this works. Given an IP address 1 0 1 1 0, we have our odd bits and our even bits. So your odd bits are 1, 1 and 0, and even bits are 0 and 1. The odd bits go into the odd trie. So when you get a 1, you go to the right. When you get another 1, you go again to the right. When you get a 0, you come to the left. And the even one will be stored 0 to the left and 1 to the right. Now how the mapping works is, given a trie, and the positions numbered as 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Now the data stored in 4 will be 0 and 1. 0 and 1. So using the formula that we had earlier, given an array, position 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Now if we get 0, we move to the left. That comes to position 1. So according to the formula, it is current index into 2. So 0 into 2 is 0 plus 1. So the position comes here. Now when we get 1, we go to 4. So the current index is 1. So 1 into 2 plus 2. That is 4. So 0, 1. You store the element in 4. So the corresponding position in the array, you should store the next hop. So here. So this is how we are mapping it.
Only where the next hop is there in a trie, that you are mapping into trie.
Explain the code. I am taking the input from 2 files, that is IP short.txt and IP destination. So this contains the IP addresses and this contains next hops. And I have 2 strings called even trie and odd trie, which I use to store the tries. And here I take each line from the IP address file and I process on it. By using the standard library available in C++, C++, I remove the dots from the IP addresses, and in this for loop, I split the IP address from its length. So, using this logic. In this position, I have separated the IP address from its length. Now this IP address exists in a string format. Now I am converting it into a long int to process on it. So using this statement, I am converting it into long and int. Now that long, I am converting it into binary using bit set function. I am converting it into a binary, 32-bit binary number. And this is where I am calculating the indexes to store the next hop. So binary left of slash is my array where I am storing the IP address. And I am processing both even and odd in the same for loop using the loop variable j jumps 2 times, and then I am processing j and j plus 1. So j will be the odd position and j plus 1 will be the even position. J will be the even position and J plus 1 will be the odd position. So the logic goes like this. If the element present at index J is 0, the current index is equal to 2 into current index plus 1. That is the formula we use. I explained earlier. If the element at the index J is 1, the index will get changed into 2 into current index plus 2. Likewise for the odd print.
How do you check in the particular index whether there is a next hop or not?
No, that is not being checked. I am not checking if there is a next hop. Now, after we find the current indexes, I store at that position in the even trie, I store the next hop, the corresponding next hop. And at that same position in the odd trie, I am storing the current corresponding next hop. Now, insertion is done. The search function is similar to the insertion function. I again receive the search input from a file, and it is stored in a variable called search IP. And the search IP again will remove all the dots and then separate the length from the IP address. Using the same logic as I did earlier, I calculate indexes again, the even index and the odd index. I run through the IP address. If the IP address bit is 0, I traverse left. So that is done by this formula, which is we see current index is equal to 2 into current index plus 1. If the bit is 1, I do 2 into current index plus 2. I do this for even and odd, and then I find the two indexes. And then I retrieve the value in the even trie of that index and the odd trie of that index, and I compare if it is the same. If it is the same, I print it, and that is the corresponding next hop.
Output?
Output, I don't know. I only have the search key.
You didn't check anything?
Huh?
You didn't check?
I didn't print the output. I mean, I didn't save the output.